What if you wanted to watch reels while a deliverable was pending? But the reel in question was the Sarkar saying,
I'm the best, I'm the best, I'm the best.
जब रिपोर्ट सर्फेस फॉर द यूपी गवर्नमेंट्स डिजिटल मीडिया पॉलिसी 2024 प्रॉमिसिंग फाइनेंशियल इंसेंटिव्स टू डिजिटल क्रिएटर्स सच एज मायसेल्फ फॉर प्रमोटिंग गवर्नमेंट स्कीम्स मतलब सरकारी इन्फ्लुएंसर मार्केटिंग द न्यूज ऑल्सो स्टेटेड समथिंग अबाउट इम्पोजिंग फाइन्स ऑन दीज क्रिएटर्स इफ दे मेड आपत्तिजनक कॉन्टेंट बट यहां आता है सरप्राइज ट्विस्ट Internet Freedom Foundation found that Haryana, Karnataka, Punjab and Himachal Pradesh also have a digital media slash influencer policy. IFF also filed RTIs for policies for a bunch of other states. You can find all the media policies already put in the public domain on IFF's blog post about this, jiska link mere bio mein hai. Ab dekho, sabka apna apna problem hai and sare uniquely problematic hai. Like Haryana's policy straight up provides the discretion for deductions in payments to said influencers. And all of the policies also have this common feature of vaguely worded provisions for cancellation of suspension with the words like objectionable or immoral making features, which means there's wide discretion of grounds for which the empanelment of a government influencer can be suspended or cancelled, as anything that can be fit into the subjective description of objectionable or immoral could be cited for this. And there's no real grievance redressal mechanism for it either in the policy. Additionally, Rajasthan, Sikkim and Assam also reportedly have a digital media policy. But again, it's not in the public domain. IFF has filed RTIs about whether there was a public consultation for these policies and also asking ki like, sir, policy kithe? And the details are very detail oriented. Here's what we think you should care about the most. The policies as we saw them reward influencers solely on the basis of follower count. Matlab expertise, objectivity, sab gaya tel lene. As long as you peddle the state supported narrative. Through such policies, highlighting government schemes and achievements is being financially incentivized and the focus is only on positive government approved narratives. The immediate concern ki aisa raha to self-censorship and moral policing will stifle creativity and free speech while influencing public perceptions of the government policies and welfare schemes. We will also mention that there is nothing necessarily illegal about this until you get to the transparency concerns. Currently, there is nothing in the policies that suggests ki there is any obligation to disclose to the viewer that this content is produced by the Sarkar. In fact, the Goa administration gave us a list of impaneled content creators in the RTI response and IFF did check them out. Hame to na dikha kahi likha hua ki sarkar sponsored tourism ad hai. Another concern with noting is that Supreme Court has already given guidelines as to what the government can advertise with the public funds and how. Common Cause versus Union of India mein likha hai ki government advertising must always follow certain principles of content regulation. Like, advertising campaigns are to be related to government responsibilities. They cannot be directed at promoting political interests of a party. Campaigns must be justified and undertaken in an efficient and cost-effective manner, and advertisements must comply with legal requirements and financial regulations and procedures, etc. There's also a Committee on Content Regulation in Government Advertising set up by the government for the enforcement of these exact guidelines. But they're criticized for being ineffective. And I mean, an RTI investigation that I conducted told us that 9,48,43,515 was spent on advertising putting selfies on hargartiranga.com. So, matlab thoda criticism mein credibility to hai, like, that's what I feel. We should also highlight that the guidelines for prevention of misleading advertisements and endorsements for misleading advertisements 2022 is a real document that exists, issued by the Ministry of Consumer Affairs. These guidelines are specifically aimed at ethical advertising and consumer protection. However, it is unclear ki how are they operationalized or how effective they are at safeguarding advertiser accountability. Before you go, IFF made a table comparing the digital media policies that were published so far. Nerd log pe to bharosa hai, but try to go through them when you can, please. And also donate to IFF because they make content like this possible. I'ma be real with you, we could hustle all day, this away, that away, through courts and parliaments, but money trees is the perfect place for shade, and at least that's how I feel.